You as a Muslim, you are seeing a scripture and you're saying, well, that's a red flag.
Your
whole Quran is a red flag. Did I add it or the printers add it? Who? Me or the printers?
It's not in manuscript.
This man is arguing about something that is written that I quoted. I only quoted what was written. And you tell me, oh, you don't like the Bible, you don't like the Bible. It wasn't in there. Who are you, a scholar?
You know.
How do you know it wasn't in there?
No.
Islam is not the scripture.
So I'm a student.
What do you mean blindly?
Can I ask a question?
You are following Islam blindly.
Can I ask a question?
You are following Islam blindly.
That cannot be true.
Okay.
Don't worry about the content. Don't worry about the content.
Ask a question.
Don't worry about the content of the Quran. The Quran as a book has no validity.
How do you know?
It cannot be valid.
How do you know?
Because it is the word of one man.
Who is that?
You know it yourself, don't ask me.
Quran is not
act like
Quran is not the word of Muhammad.
You know it yourself.
Quran is not the word of Muhammad.
It is the word of one messenger.
It's one messenger. Quran is the word of
one messenger.
Word of God, not lie. Liar. Quran is the word of God, not Muhammad.
He's an advocate.
Liar. Yes.
He was a Christian. Would Jesus be there?
Are you saying rape is murder before? Jesus.
No, when he was Christian.
He cannot be a Christian.
So there's no such thing as a Christian rapist?
A Christian rapist? How do you put the two together?
What about the Crusades? What did they do?
Listen. Calling yourself a Muslim and being a Muslim, you know, they are two different things. Calling yourself a Christian and being a Christian are two different things. Saying I follow Jesus and actually following him is two different things.
No.
So you see, there are things we may not know right now, but you know what?
If I kill somebody, I can't be Christian.
Why would you kill somebody?
Look at Christians have done in history.
Why do you always go towards the negative?
Why God gave his own son?
You cannot be a Christian and be a thief, a lawyer, and a murderer.
Do you lie?
Me?
Have you ever lied?
About what?
When you're a Christian?
Anything, man.
Anything.
What do you mean?
Do
I lie?
Yeah, can you lie?
I've never lied.
Did you lie before?
Oh, yes.
Before, yeah. But after you became a Christian, now you're perfect.
What do you mean? I'm not perfect.
So what sins do you commit?
But watch it.
As a Christian, do you lie?
As a Christian, you're saying that I can't be a Christian.
Listen to me. My mind is not sin focused. Yeah. My mind is not. My mind is not focused on sin. So I don't think about
it. As a Christian, do you
lie? So you don't sin?
You don't listen to what I'm saying. My mind is not focused on sin.
Okay? But you have to use what the Bible is. You don't know the Bible. Many heresy and contradiction. You don't know the Bible, so get done. Get done. You don't know the Bible. You don't know the Bible, so get done.
But you know it.
What's the second commandment?
I don't know it.
What's the second commandment?
I don't know it.
And you mean?
Yes, it's you know. But you know what? You and I have forgiven before. And you know that you're one of the most confused people I've ever met. You're confused. What do you believe?
Confused for what?
What do you believe?
Confused for what?
About what you believe? What do you believe?
You confused about
what? I'm asking you, what do you believe? Tell us what you believe.
I believe in the God of Abraham. One God of Abraham.
And there was?
One God of Abraham.
Who's the God of Isaac?
Huh?
Who's the God of Isaac?
The God of Isaac?
Yes.
Yeah, the God of Abraham, same God.
No, I'm asking you, who's the God of Isaac?
Same God.
Who's the God of Jacob?
Same God, the God of Mary.
Who's the God of Israel?
Who's the God of Mary?
You're confused.
Who's the God of Mary?
You see, I mentioned it earlier on.
Answer me now, who's the God of Mary?
I said it to you earlier on.
Who's the God of
what
Mary?
What do you believe? What do you believe?
I just said it to you, the God of Abraham.
Yes.
God.
Yeah, but is that all? You just believe the God of Abraham, that's all you believe.
What's the problem?
What do you believe about him?
You have a problem with that?
I'm asking you, what do you believe
he's
about
him? He's not a man. He's the creator of the heavens and the earth.
Yes.
So what's the problem, man? He's one.
Can he become a man?
No, he said he's not. He said he's not a man.
No, but can he become a man?
Says who? You.
No, I'm asking you. You said
can
he's
he,
not a man.
Can he lie?
God is not a man.
Can he lie?
He can never lie. So I'm asking you, can he become a man? Can he become a man?
Can he become a man?
Yes.
That's nice quality. Can he be? Bible says.
I'm asking you. Answer me.
Can I answer you?
Yes, you can.
Quiet. Let me answer you.
Yes.
In the book of Acts,
yes.
Your Bible says
yes.
God says, "I am the creator of all man.
Yes.
You know what all mean?
All means all.
That means no man is leave out the picture.
So since
no man's left out.
No man left out the picture.
Yeah.
Everybody.
So since he created all man,
yes,
there's no man exists for him to become.
You're confused. You see, I'm missing.
Oh,
Now watch it. Becoming a man and creator of all mankind. Listen, God created Adam and Eve. Since then, everybody has been born through Adam and Eve. So when you say God created, are you talking about an original creation? You're confused. I told you you're confused.
Wait.
Are you confused? So you say, well, God is the creator of all mankind. So can God? You're asking a question that is not really crazy.
Since Adam and Eve,
so
everybody has been born.
Yes.
I'm a Christian. Are you Christian?
I'm a believer.
Is your source of information the Bible? Is Jesus and the only ones that have not born of a woman?
Come again?
Is Jesus and Adam and Eve the only ones in the Bible that have not been born of a man or a woman?
Like, no, but Jesus was born of a woman.
And a man, I think. Here I said a man and a woman.
Yeah, but it wasn't born of a man.
As in, Adam and Eve were created directly by God.
Yes.
And so was Jesus.
Jesus wasn't created directly by God.
Okay.
So he was in the womb.
Conceived.
Of Mariam.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Conceived.
So
conceived
that is different from
Adam. Conceived is a man and woman coming together.
Adam and Eve.
Wait. So conceived is a man and a woman coming together.
Yes.
Yeah? That didn't happen with Jesus.
No, it doesn't happen.
Exactly. And that didn't happen with Adam.
So what's your question?
I'm asking it. That didn't happen with Adam and Eve.
Yes.
Are they the only three in the Bible?
Come again.
Are they the only three in the Bible that are basically exempt from how we were created?
No. I would say we were born.
Yes.
We are part of creation.
Yeah.
Jesus too was also born. So you can't leave him out of that. Yeah. Ever since Adam and Eve, every human being has been born of a woman.
No, I don't.
When you say are they the only three, three in what sense?
As in,
there's no comparison.
If you mention
Adam and Jesus, I understand, because the Bible talks about Adam and Jesus. It calls Adam in the beginning, the first Adam. It calls Jesus the second Adam. Yeah. So that's a different issue.
Okay, we're going on the tangent. Yeah, the original thing you said.
Yes.
Yeah. Apart from Adam, Eve,
yes,
and Jesus, everyone else was born of Adam and Eve. That's what you said.
No, that's not what I mean. That's not my point. My point to you.
You did say it.
My point to you is that Adam and Eve were created originally.
Okay.
But since then, everybody has been born of a woman. That's my point. Jesus was born of a woman. My exception of Jesus is that Miriam gave Jesus a body by the power of the Holy Spirit. You don't.
Jesus come out. We can
go. No, you don't. You don't. The Quran has a different idea than the scriptures.
Okay. Well, I'm telling you, I'm Muslim. We agree that Jesus came out of Mary. We got a whole chapter about it, and you agree the same thing. What I'm trying to say to you is there anyone else in the Bible that wasn't conceived that way? I'm questioning you about your scripture.
Adam and Eve is the only one.
Adam
and Eve were the only ones who were not conceived, but Jesus was conceived.
So they're the only ones.
Yes, Adam and Eve.
I'll see you next week. Check that on your Bible. Check that properly on your Bible.
What do you mean?
Check that properly. I'm not going to give you the information. You need to go and watch your own Bible.
Yeah, but what is your point?
My point is, go and find out if there's anyone else in the Bible, I can assure you there is, that was not born, not created.
We'll change the topic.
Yeah?
We'll change the subject.
And he's a man. Go and check.
Well, you're going to give me Melchizedek. That's the issue.
I'm not going to give you nothing. Don't even go there.
Just because of what you read and your interpretation. You have to realize that when you read the scriptures and you interpret, because there is no lineage. There's no lineage of Melchizedek Megan in the Bible.
But what does it claim? What does the Bible claim about it?
Yeah, but it says.
It says,
without father, without mother, without beginning. Yeah, what about it?
So explain that.
Well, I'll tell you something.
Because you said let me be honest with you.
I don't know everything. So the question you ask me, I don't know it.
You've already answered.
Yeah, what do you mean? I've already answered it. I mentioned, I quoted the scripture.
Yes.
And you're asking me a question. I said I don't know. Yeah, but it says
about a man or a woman.
No, it didn't say no. That's what it. That's what it says.
Yes, but it's basically the same thing.
No, no, your implication. That's your implication.
Okay,
but watch this. My opinion, yeah, is that what we are debating about is insignificant to your eternal soul, because I'm more concerned about your soul.
Hold on. Okay, you are. I agree. And I'll shake your hand. Thank you for being.
I'm concerned about your soul.
Thank you for being.
So let me ask
guess
you.
What?
If you die, concerned. Where will you go?
Guess what? I'm also concerned about my soul. Yeah.
That's good. Listen, I don't see many Muslims concerned about their soul.
Yes. Yes. Hence why people are talking about this. What I'm trying to say to you, if you are then concerned, you need to verify. If you're saying one thing and your scripture is saying another.
What did I say? I never said anything different from the scriptures.
So you highlighted three people.
Yes.
In history.
Yes.
Biblical history.
Yes. I said apart from Adam and Eve. I didn't say three. I said apart from Adam and Eve, everybody else has been born of a woman.
And I asked you, who?
Yeah, but when you mention Melchizedek, I'm saying to you, when it comes to Melchizedek, there isn't a clarity. There isn't enough information.
Exactly.
There isn't enough information. Yeah, but we can't. Yeah, but I'm saying to you, even if we go, what we know, what does it change? It doesn't save you. Does it save you?
What
your salvation is born. Your salvation.
100%.
Yes.
What it does show me is this is a big red flag.
For what? Red flag about what? Red flag about what?
You're telling me this person is not created.
Yes.
What
are you telling me? I'm telling you and I have referred to the scripture.
My brother.
Yeah?
See, when you
and
speak,
we are
agreed. I'm not quiet. No, no.
Yeah, fine.
Just hear me.
But you're making a point. I don't want you to run away with that point.
No.
I want us to deal with it.
We're not running away. I'm actually explaining the point.
Yes.
I'm saying it's a red flag.
In what sense?
It's a red flag. As in, you can't explain this important person that has no.
How does that say?
How does it say?
Yes.
Well, it protects you from believing what's going on here. Because if that's a flag.
If you, a Muslim, are protected by what you see in a scripture as a red flag. In your very book, you as a Muslim, you are seeing a scripture and you're saying, well, that's a red flag.
You said to me,
your whole Quran is a red flag.
Wait.
Your whole Quran is a red herring.
Now you said, wait.
It's not a red herring.
Now you said, let's talk about the topic and not go.
It's the truth. It is a word. The Quran is a word of one man.
Brother, you said to me, you don't want to jump.
Quran has no witness.
Okay.
Yeah.
You asked me not to jump to another topic, right?
No, I'm not jumping to another topic.
You just started talking about the Quran.
We have there, but you're saying you're pointing to it. You said that's a red flag, and I said wait.
You asked
red flag on one scripture.
Your question was,
and I'm saying to you,
how do we get to that? That was your question.
Yeah, but then when you question the scripture, I'm saying,
hold on.
What about your Quran?
Listen, you asked me.
Yes.
How does that protect me?
Yes.
Yeah? My answer was, because of the red flag, it's protecting me.
But what point are we reasoning about?
I'm actually answering you.
No,
I'm answering you.
My point to you.
You, as a Muslim, your background is the whole red flag.
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay. And then
you say to me,
how is my background?
I have seen one scripture, it's a red flag. Hey, and I'm saying, that is not true.
Here's the shovel. Tell me how my background is.
My issue with you is that we
have an issue with me.
Okay. Not an issue. An issue about what we're discussing. My issue is that there are scriptures that we believe in. Yeah?
There are
scriptures that we believe in.
I believe in the Quran.
Exactly. I believe in the Bible, you believe in the Quran.
So,
but my issue is that when you begin with discussions, the Bible came before the Quran.
No. The Bible didn't came.
Because
it's a lie.
Yes.
And the question is,
wait, go.
The Bible and the Quran, are they the same?
Wait. You said the Bible came before the Quran.
Yes.
Go.
So,
am I right in saying,
yes,
for that statement, I should be going to the source and not what comes after?
Yes. It's the Bible.
Not necessarily.
It's the Bible before the Torah.
What do you mean?
No, the
Torah is part of the Bible. No, I don't follow the New Testament. I follow the whole Bible from Genesis to Revelation.
Okay, so
when I say Bible, I mean Genesis to Revelation.
Okay, so which laws do you follow?
What do you mean?
They're not the same
one law. One law.
Not the same law.
The law of love.
They're not laws.
Jesus Christ came to preach.
Where's the love in the Old Testament?
You shall love your neighbor as yourself.
Where is the love in the Old Testament?
Love God and love your neighbor.
Wait,
that is one law from Jesus.
Love in the Old Testament.
What do you mean?
Where is the love in the Old Testament?
Oh, there's lots of love.
Yeah.
You know, Abraham walked with God. Abraham was a friend of God. God loved him. He loved God.
That's a question.
Are you with me?
I'll be allowed to answer. Watch me. I'm asking you. Papa is there.
See? Hello. We are learning from you.
We were discussing before about the divinity of God.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it seems like
the divinity of God. How can you describe the divinity of God? Not divine. So how do you describe the divinity?
Can you just listen to my chance?
Okay, I'm asking you a question.
Can I please speak?
Yes, go on.
Okay.
Because your question is very. Your question is not a question.
Okay.
You are discussing the divinity of
God. Correct him. Then let him go there.
Let him finish. Before you correct
him. Let him finish.
I'm not correcting him. I'm saying let us be clear of what we are discussing. And there is no clarity. My point is be clear. Otherwise, I can't answer you. I can't answer a confused question. If you're asking me a question, you have to be clear with the question. Then I can give you an answer. So I'm saying clarify your question. Clarify your question. That's what I'm asking you.
Maybe your perception is unclear.
Okay. No, your perception or mine?
No, my perception is unclear.
Okay.
Can I answer that?
Yeah, I'm listening.
We're speaking about the nature of who Jesus is.
Now there you are. That's good. The nature. No, I'm agreeing with you. I agree with you.
Man, you can't let us. You can't let my fish a pint.
Give him
the okay.
Because we're about, says, wait. Talking about love, love your brother and let him talk.
I'm listening to him.
Love him and let him talk.
Wussi, yes, come on. About theology then. About the topic of theology.
Okay.
And we're talking about God. No, you jump from that to speaking about asking questions, making point about scripture with no direction. Where are we getting to? Speaking about God, speaking about people is a difference. God is the greatest, God should be more important to speak about. That's speaking about people. Me, I'm a Muslim. You're a Christian. Well, my prophet tell me, when speaking to the Christian, a people of the book, talk about the concept of God first, the oneness of God. Yes. So, yeah. So we want to know if who you see as a, we talk, remember he says, I said Abraham, the God of Abraham, is the one God. And then we start to talk about who that one God is. That's where we are. Or do you jump from that to somewhere else? No, you say Jesus is the one God. How come Jesus is that one God? That's my point. That's where we're going to discuss.
I said Jesus is the one God.
Okay. The question is an ancient problem. This is an ancient problem they have.
Give him a chance to talk.
There's an ancient problem they have.
So you said, God are in parts.
For you, for human understanding, because our human mind is limited in concepts. Let me ask you a question.
So why we can't understand it.
Why would God in the beginning keep emphasizing, I am one God, I am one God, I am one God? Because God knows when we discover His Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, so as we think there's three gods. And so in the beginning, God says, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one God. Yes? So that even the day when God reveals, I am Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you know He's only one God.
You're just in one. I'm going to rip
it. Are you talking? Are you preaching? Are you talking?
I'm talking.
Yes. I'm short and I can't hear you.
I'm saying. So you said before.
God keeps saying there's one God. Moses, Aaron, God says one God. Hosea 11 verse 9, God is the Amman. Yes. Numbers 23 verse 1.
No other God, only that one God.
Yes, clearly God is the Amman, not His creation. But you say no when God comes to Jesus. I'm asking you to say yes. When God comes to Jesus, all of a sudden, God is a divisible God. He's not just one God alone. That's what you're saying?
No. That's what you understand.
I'm asking you.
Yeah, so I'm explaining to you, that in Jesus Christ, the Word became flesh. He says in the beginning was the Word. He says the Word was with God. Which is in Islam, you need to say that the Quran is the Word of God. Yeah? He's speaking to me right now. He's speaking your words. Your words are you. I wouldn't know what you're thinking. I said, So we understand that God is the word.
So far,
am I making?
Are you talking about the Bible verse?
Forget about the Bible.
I like to speak about scripture and canon.
Okay. John chapter 1 verse 1. Let's go there. That's what I'm speaking about.
Marriage and teaching.
Yes.
The outcome, the human reasoning.
Yes.
Don't put above God.
Okay.
The Bible says evil. So the Bible says don't lean at your own understanding.
Yes.
So I don't have time for you, my man. I want to know what God says.
Okay. Cool. That's what I said. So, in the beginning was the Word.
Yeah.
The Word was with God. The Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him. Earlier on, your friends were telling me, "Oh, I'm a heretic just because I said well, one third plus one third, one third, so I said, three. No, I'm using the concept. It says the Word was with God, and the Word was God. I mean, how do you understand?
On a human level, you're not reasoning.
Yes,
he says you're a heretic because he said, "Who said God is?" I'll tell you what he said.
Okay.
So he says, okay. One turn is not the all itself. One turn is part of all.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Yeah.
So that's what I said. So he was using reasoning and philosophy according to you both are using. Mm-hmm. When you said that.
Yeah.
If you think of a Bible verse, why are you saying that?
Yeah.
But when you said that, I think of the second commandment in Exodus.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to forbid you for making a simile.
No, he said you don't make an image. That wasn't what I meant. Thou shalt not make any image.
No, you don't stop me. Continue.
Are you mean?
You don't stop me.
Yeah, but wait. Where did I make the image? Did I make Jesus? Did I make the Holy Spirit? This is from the scripture itself. But go on. Correct me. I want you to correct me. Yeah, but go on. You do the justice.
I want to speak. You quote Exodus 18 verse 20.
Mm-hmm.
But you do no justice to it.
Mm-hmm.
Because you say God says don't make no image and you stop there. No.
Mm-hmm.
That's not where it stops. There's a comma and it continues.
Mm-hmm.
Nor
mm-hmm.
any likeness
mm-hmm.
of anything.
Mm-hmm.
The likeness is different from the image.
Mm-hmm.
Image is like I'm explaining what I go along.
Mm-hmm.
Image is like what the Catholic Church doing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And remember, don't forget what you began to speak. I like what you said. He says, thou shalt not make. Isn't that what he said?
Yeah, I'm not talking about image.
No. I'm saying to you. He said, God was saying, thou shalt not image. Isn't that right?
Yeah, God.
So the question is, are you saying that we make Jesus? I'm asking you. Are you saying that we make Jesus?
Can I finish? That is order. That's the second commandment.
Yes.
That is order in you. It's a commandment. That is instructing you.
Yes.
Not to do something.
What? But do what? Do what?
Can I finish? Bro?
Yes.
Because when you said, don't show make image.
Yes.
That wasn't the only part of the second commandment.
Because
you didn't continue the verse.
Go on.
Then there's a comma and a continue. And then yes. It says, no, any likeness.
Mm-hmm.
The likeness that God talk about there not to make
yes.
is different from the image.
Mm-hmm.
The image is anything that you can engrave. Could you mm-hmm. engrave an image in your mind?
Uh-huh. I like that. That's true.
You're not allowed to do it as God.
Yes.
You could have sculpture like what the Catholic Church do.
Yes.
You're not allowed to do anything on earth
yes.
and say it is God. No
yes.
image, no form.
Okay.
But in the mind already in the outward.
Okay.
That's the first part.
Okay.
Then the second part, God also instructs you. Now, any likeness,
mm-hmm.
similes, no.
Mm-hmm.
Of anything,
mm-hmm.
open statement.
Mm-hmm.
Anything found in the heaven, because mm-hmm. open, meaning the whole entire heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Anything found on the earth, because open, meaning the whole entire earth.
Mm-hmm.
Or the water body beneath the earth.
Mm-hmm.
That's the first verse. God forbid in those three places,
mm-hmm.
don't make no similes.
Mm-hmm.
Likeness, similes, mm-hmm. always like ours.
Mm-hmm.
Do not make no similes.
Mm-hmm.
No, because in this created era, this created zone,
mm-hmm.
where human beings live in,
mm-hmm.
and human beings raiders can only person within those great zone,
mm-hmm.
but can't person everything.
Mm-hmm.
Anything you grasp in those zone,
mm-hmm.
you're not allowed to say it is like God.
Mm-hmm.
The moment you say something in heaven, or the earth, or the water, is like God,
mm-hmm.
you breach the second commandment.
Can I ask a question then?
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I get you what you're saying, but can I ask a question? You've been talking.
Yeah. I'm going to close this.
Okay.
So when you were making the analogy, you know,
yes.
with an earthly, with the analogy, with a mathematical analogy,
yes.
about with numbers, or yes. one or These are our earthly counterparts, earthly things, and earth here. Yes? When we're using that as an analogy, analogy is also a comparison which is stronger than simile. Simile is comparison, analogy, stronger comparison, metaphor. You are using that analogy to say what God is. This is what I'm saying. You can't command me.
But do you know what I understand? Tell me when you want to speak.
I
understand what you're saying.
Because you are using something on earth.
But you are incomplete. What you're saying is incomplete.
No, you are using something on earth to make a comparison, analogy of what God is, his essence. What God is and what God does is two different things. You can use comparison by scripture. Even in the Quran, it's about Bible. There's no when I read both of those scripture, there's no dispute on that point. Where we can make a an analogy with behavior of all certain functions with what God does. But what God is, his essence, is infinite, divine essence is different. You can't use a comparison with no earthly thing, nothing in the event to do that. Because
so are you telling me that God doesn't teach us about himself through various concepts of things he's done in the earth?
I said to you, what God does is
different. My point is that what you're saying is incomplete.
What God does is different.
No, I'm not saying about that. I'm talking about the fact that you're saying you shall not make any comparisons or any image.
It's a commandment. It's clear.
Wait. You told me I didn't do all of it. Yet you didn't do all of it. He says you will not bow down to them or worship them. So it wasn't the making part. You see, you are so focused on you shall not make. But then why are you making? You're making for a purpose to do what? To worship. And God is saying, don't do it.
So
but watch it. Give me a chance.
God
is saying the whole idea is that don't worship anything else.
But do you worship Jesus?
Because Jesus is God.
No, please, just don't listen.
He is God. I worship him.
You worship Jesus?
Yes, I do.
Was Jesus on earth?
What do you mean?
Was Jesus ever on earth?
He came to
was death. Was he in one of those places where God forbid you to make a sin?
But let me see.
Go slow.
No, you go. You've been talking.
Go slow. You know why you're running.
Running? For where? You don't want to hear the truth.
The
question he said, was Jesus on earth? I want to ask you.
No, because he said,
where did he come from?
Because he said,
no, wait.
He said,
where did he come from?
Is that a question?
No, answer me.
I'm on your point.
No. Your point. Have you seen your point? No, you were saying on earth.
You said the reason why.
Listen to me.
You said you're not making it.
I'm asking you a question. Where did Jesus come from?
Can we finish second?
No, answer that. Answer me first.
You said something important.
Answer me first. Where did he come from?
You said something important.
Yeah, I know, but I'm saying, where did he come from?
Don't forget that.
But I want us to answer that one before we go on. Let's answer that one
before
we go on.
Because there was a point that before that.
Wait. Where did he come from? I can answer you. Jesus was God before he became a man, and after he became a man, he was still God. It didn't stop him from being God.
What?
But you see, you want to reduce him to just a human being. In Islam, Jesus is just a human being. But from the scriptures, he's not.
That's even against the Bible.
He existed. He told the Jews before Abraham was, I am. Where did that happen? At Moses meeting God at the burning bush. Moses said to God,
can you come?
Ask me, come. Who sent me?
Every verse
what should I say?
Everything you caught.
Moses
everything
was told by God.
Everything you caught.
Tell them, I am.
Everything,
I sent you.
Everything you caught.
So when
you
Jesus says to the Jews, I am.
I heard you, but you don't understand that. Do you recognize, study?
You, the Muslim who is in darkness and telling me
I know
who is following Christ the light, and then I haven't studied.
Can I please?
All I need to know is that Jesus Christ is the light.
I heard the incorrect point.
So you
I heard all the
point. You accept
can I answer
that
the point?
Jesus Christ
can
is the light?
You, can I
answer me? No, answer me.
That's a different point. You give me three.
So you keep running all over the place.
No.
Let's go back to where we started.
Am I running? I heard the point.
You were debating about the issue.
Can I say
what? You are debating about the issue of Jesus,
an
image that we made and we're worshiping.
Can I answer?
Go ahead and answer.
When I speak, I quote Bible verse for you. I don't speak on my backside.
Yes.
And when I
quote Bible verse, you quote about Jesus.
I said the second commandment.
No. The second
Exodus.
I've answered you, but why you keep?
You have an answer.
Stop it.
Can I please?
I said to you.
and a priest at the same church.
Yeah, but you're
because still saying it already.
No, because you have mentioned the fact, and I'm saying to you, Jesus does not equate in what you're saying. He is not part of what
I'm
you're saying.
I'm sure you're incorrect. I'm sure. Can I show you?
What, can I show you incorrect in what sense?
Can I show you incorrect?
Incorrect in what sense?
The verse in the second commandment.
Yes.
God forbid you.
Yes.
From making a simile with anything you find in that. Day.
But Jesus is more than a simile.
Can I finish?
You see, that's your confusion. You keep going back.
Can I finish? Can I finish?
Invalid.
Can I finish?
You just want to say your point and get it off your chest.
Can I finish?
Do you want the truth or
can
not?
Can I finish?
Do you want the truth or not?
You don't like the commandment.
No, you
hate the second commandment. You hate the second commandment so bad.
Because you know what?
You want to prove yourself that you don't.
Because you know what? Because you know what?
You hate the Bible.
Jesus Christ is the fulfillment of all the commandments.
You hate the verse. What does he mean when he says that?
It means
you don't know. I don't know what
to represent
I can tell
in
you what
righteousness
means.
Everything no. That oh you can tell me what it means. That's your point. You want to tell me what it means by
Bible,
you?
I can read the Bible. Show you.
I can read too. I can read as well. And I'm saying to you, Jesus says in Him. The law and the prophets are fulfilled in the person of Jesus Christ. Did you know that?
What does it mean by that?
That means He came to fulfill the law and the prophets.
What does it mean by that?
They had been prophesying about His coming.
What does it?
The law mentioned His coming.
Preaching.
The prophets mentioned His coming. Jesus Christ came to fulfill the law and the prophets by obeying all of it. Not even one little title. He fulfilled all of it.
He came from where?
Yet the Jews accused Him of breaking the law. And He told them, what do you think? I am here to fulfill the law that God told me to fulfill.
So, okay.
So if I heal somebody on the Sabbath day and you are upset because you think I'm breaking the Sabbath,
he's just talking for
you. There you are. You don't want to hear the truth. If you want to win an argument, you've won. You win. You need Jesus.
I used to be a sinner like you.
Jesus needs God.
I used to be a sinner like
you. But Jesus needs God now. I met Jesus.
Yes.
Heard about preaching about Jesus.
Preaching.
I need to repent.
I will reason. The Bible said you was reason.
So man was preaching about Jesus.
The Bible said you was reason.
And told me I should repent.
Who's Jesus?
And when I repented,
who's Jesus?
Jesus is the Word of God, the Son of God.
The Bible said you was reason.
The Word of God, flesh.
Word of
God. The Bible said you was reason.
Word of God. The Word became flesh.
By who? Made flesh by who? The Word has made flesh by who?
By the Word Himself. You see? You don't have brain.
I'm confused.
They say that God has made the flesh.
The Word became.
No, see, don't lie.
It wasn't made. The Word became.
Don't lie.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was God. The same
the Word was God.
All things were made by Him.
Can I?
In the beginning was. The Word became flesh.
No way.
Not made.
Has been made flesh.
So we hear you.
From where?
We hear you.
That is a demonic scripture.
So we hear you. What's
King James?
Only devils who say the Word was created.
King James.
I've got King James here.
Okay, read.
Let me read it.
You know why it says
in manuscript?
No. I'm gonna go deeper. Forget about English, man. You know why it says in manuscript? I'm not sure you ever studied. You know what that verse says in manuscript in Greek? Can you read it? Do you know what it says in Greek?
What do you mean?
The verse that you just quote.
What about that? What does it say in Greek? What about what? Okay,
can I speak?
I'm saying, but he's a believer. He's asking what you know about the Greek.
Can I speak?
But let me ask you. How will Greek save your soul?
Can I?
Yeah, because you want to debate. I want to reach your soul.
So what's going
to
say?
I want to win your soul for Jesus, not to debate you.
Debate
is taking you to hell.
What's
debating? You will debate it and go to hell. Right. You know that? You keep debating. It won't save your soul. Your soul needs to be saved.
Can I speak?
Are you a sinner?
Can I speak now?
I used to be a sinner.
Can I speak now?
I repented from sin and gave my life to Jesus Christ.
When I finish, I speak.
And I'm saying to you, will you repent and give your life to Jesus Christ? Will you do that?
Can I speak?
No, I'm asking you.
This one just wants
to win an argument. Like, he wants to make his point. Speaker's corner. I'm not here for that. I'm here to win souls. I'm here to tell people, turn from darkness and turn to the light. That's why I'm here. I didn't come here to debate. I want to, debate. I'm not interested in debating. I'm here to reach your soul.
I'm listening.
I want you to look at yourself and ask yourself,
if you should die, where would you go? That's my only question. If I'm going to die one day I will die. One day you will die. One day you will die. And for me, I came to speak at Skona to tell people, look at your soul, the condition of your soul, and ask yourself, what will happen to your soul when you die? I know what will happen to me, but do you know what will happen to me?
Can I speak now?
Are you going to speak about your soul?
Are you more bothered about yourself? Am I important? I can't speak.
No, my point is that I don't. Listen, if you want to debate, find somebody to debate.
I'm not debating.
I came here to reach soul.
The Bible said use reason. I want to reason with you.
What? You're not reasoning. I've told you right now. Okay, you want to reason? Are you a sinner?
Reason, I'm not reasoning because
are you a sinner?
Reason, I'm not reasoning because you won't give me a chance to reason. These people achieved me a while ago. I'm
okay, what is your reason?
Are Christians meant to be so unfair?
They want to win an argument. That's what you're asking.
I'm asking you. Who's talking about winning?
You want to win an argument. I'm saying you've won.
The Bible says use reason.
You've won the
Bible. Your Bible. Why don't you like to follow your own Bible? Why don't you like to follow your own Bible? Why you hate the Bible?
Quran, which cannot be true.
Why you hate your Bible so much?
You believe in the Quran.
Why you hate your Bible so much? Why you hate the Bible so much?
I can't believe you.
The Bible says use reason. Your Bible says use reason. But you want to have a monologue.
I used to be a sinner.
Yeah, but I said you.
Yeah, my monologue is that you need Jesus. That's my monologue. You're right. I'm arguing. I'm on a monologue that you need Jesus. Don't you think so?
Can I speak now?
Why are you so? You're so set on airing your opinion.
4 minutes, 5 minutes. Oh, I'm gonna be quiet. So I'm gonna go on.
No. Do you know what? If this is for the camera, then I will say cut. I'm off.
Which camera? I'm off.
Yeah, but I'm saying
to you. No, you're Christian.
My point is that.
Your friends is not my friends.
Point is that
I came here alone.
You need Jesus.
My camera is on my phone in my pocket.
You need Jesus. That's why I came. Honestly, if you want to argue, you can go sit somewhere and argue.
So,
if I came to Spirit X Corner to reach out Muslims who are lost, not just Muslims, but anybody who wants to believe in Jesus.
I should accept the Nile. Can I ask
you? No, you can't.
Can I ask the question?
Sorry, but what's your question?
Can I ask the question?
Of course you can. What's your question then?
Okay.
But your question has to relate to your soul and Jesus saving your soul.
So are we talking about
that's all I can answer about.
So who is all one can say?
Jesus.
It's not the Bible church.
What does
it mean? Jesus says, the Bible, Hebrews 5 verse 7. Jesus himself, when he says all one can say, will pray to someone else.
Yes.
With strong crying tears.
Yes.
To the one that was
Hebrews 5 verse 7.
Can I finish?
I'm letting you know I know what they are saying.
So the one who you said is the only one can save.
Yes.
You said a while ago,
yes,
just is the only one can save.
Yes.
Your Bible saying that you are a liar. Because if can I finish?
Isn't it incredible how
can I finish? I'm giving reference to what I say.
Yes.
I give proof when I speak.
Okay.
Hebrews 5 verse 7. You believe these good words?
I believe it.
Yes, so God is saying, Jesus, the one who says all one can say.
Yes.
Jesus is praying with strong cry and tears.
You don't even understand it, so don't even go
there. Can I finish?
Oh, you haven't finished yet. What can you go?
Jesus was praying in 5 verse 7.
Yes.
I like to go just the Bible.
Now I mentioned it, now you mentioned it. You should have told it from the beginning.
When you quote the Bible, I'm a Christian. I'm a Christian.
Yeah.
I should never do that. When you quote the Bible,
your mother is praying for your soul.
You're going to strain on. Can I make a point?
No, your name is important to me. What's your name?
Don't worry about my name.
No, what's your name?
My name is Abdul.
Abdul.
Yes.
Okay. What was the name they gave you? What's the
name? Digestion.
No, but I see you. I mean,
it's about soul saving. It's about soul saving.
What is your
name?
What name did they give you?
I thought it was about important.
What name did they give you?
I thought it was important about saving soul. Not about my name.
What name did they give you? I
just want to know.
But I know.
I thought you said what important about saving soul.
I know, but I'm asking you.
Before someone saw the soul.
What name did they give you at birth?
First of all,
I'm interested in you.
But before you contradict yourself, no, you said
it's okay.
Why worry about the soul?
You tell me your name.
I agree with you.
Yeah, but what's your Christian name? What was your Christian name?
You see, you all want to no,
I can't believe you. You don't even want to tell me.
Respect.
That's okay. I'm listening now.
5 minutes, no respect.
Go.
You see, first thing, you cannot bring no one to Christian. I tell you why. Because you have no respect for them as a person. And you look at them and say, you know what? This guy can't even attract me. Because there's no decorum when he is out. You see, for 4 or 5 minutes, it's about winning no points. You see, the important thing about saving the soul, I said, I agree, saving the soul. Let's talk about the verse about who's going to save, who's the only one can save now. You worry about name? Trivial stuff.
It's not trivial. Your name is not trivial.
So I thought it was about
your name is important.
But before you said it's about saving the soul, I said let's talk about saving the soul. Why you want to digress again? You said Jesus is the only one can say it in 5 verse 7 says no.
That's not true.
Jesus himself.
I don't agree with you.
The only one who
can. And I'll tell you why.
Can I finish the verse?
Yeah, go.
Hebrews 5 verse 7. Jesus in the days of his flesh was praying.
Yes.
Strong crying, strong tears, and supplication.
Mm-hmm.
Strong
crying and tears.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
To the one that was able, to the one that was able to save him.
From what?
From death.
Uh-huh.
So if
you know what that means?
Hold on, please.
See, you think
please,
you know?
Please, when I finish.
I'm listening to you.
You said no, Jesus is the only one can save.
Yes.
So if he's the only one can save, that in 5 verse 7 clearly indicates that he was praying to someone else who can save him.
Yes.
That's clear.
Yes.
So it's contradict what you're saying.
Can we break it down now? Let's go back to the verse you mentioned. You forgot to say crying with praise and tears, to him. And what he says, in the days of his flesh. Yeah. Jesus didn't save anybody in the days of his flesh. It was the death of Jesus that saved us. His tears. Not his life. In the days of his flesh, he cried to him who could save him from death. But in his death, he saved mankind.
So who was he crying to?
He was crying to the Father in the days of his flesh.
The one.
But in his death, he saved humanity from hell and death. So when I say to you, only Jesus can save humanity. Yes, he himself in the days of his flesh cried. You mentioned, I agree with you. So strong tears in the days of his flesh.
So he's not God in the days of his flesh.
As an human being.
He's not God.
He's God. Brother, you see why I asked your name? I would have called your name right now. See, why do you, why can't you? But you get the point where it says, okay, you get the point where it says, in the days of his flesh. You read that? You read that? In the days of his flesh. But in his death, that is where he saves mankind, not his flesh.
Says who?
The scriptures.
In his death.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that anyone that believes in him should not perish but have life.
John 3:16.
And then watch it. Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. If you will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved.
Who says that?
Pause. Scripture.
Pause.
See,
let me tell you. Can I speak?
Give me your name. Give me your name. What was your Christian name?
Brother,
you don't want to tell me. What's your Christian name?
I'm about scripture. I'm talking about scripture.
Tell me your Christian name, then I'll answer.
I'm talking about scripture.
What was your name before you became a Muslim?
What was
your Christian name?
What's my name important now?
Because don't you know my name? My name is Daniel. What's your name?
Raw.
How do you spell
that? R-O-R-R-E. Raw. Are you laughing?
You're not laughing. You're not lying to me, are you?
Why are you laughing?
No, because I'm thinking just, you said call me Raw.
Why is it?
I'm thinking, are you joking?
I said call me Raw. That's it. Call me Raw.
Raw.
Yeah, I'll give you something to reference. Okay.
No, you see, there you are. You give me something, not your name. I want your name, not something.
I didn't say I give you a lie.
Yeah, but... Oh my gosh.
Did I say I give you a lie? Why is it important? I said call me Raw. What's the problem?
Because I would have said Raw, listen to me.
You can still say...
And my point to you is that you mention about Jesus Christ in the days of his flesh. And I'm saying to you, it was his death that brought salvation, not the days of his flesh.
That's not the point we're talking about saying. Who can say?
Yeah, but salvation. Salvation comes through the death and resurrection of
where,
Jesus Christ.
Show me where in the Bible after Jesus. Please.
Go on.
Hear what I'm going to ask you. Show me where in the Bible where God says, not Paul says, can I finish?
God speaks through Paul.
Okay.
Where does, do you know who Paul is?
Where does God speak?
No, do you know who Paul is?
Can I finish a point?
I'm asking you, do you know who Paul is? No, I'm asking you. You're castigating Paul, and I'm saying, do you know who he is?
I'm in the middle of asking you a question.
Yeah, but I'm answering you. Do you know who Paul is?
He's straight now.
Thank you very much. Probably not the Paul I know. Because there is a Paul, called an apostle, who used to be called Saul. Yeah? He used to be called Saul, and he became Paul. Yeah? After he met Jesus Christ on the road to Damascus.
I'm listening to you.
Well, yeah, but you know what? I believe you. God, your mother is praying for you right now. Your mother is praying for you.
Don't mention my mother. Don't mention my mother. It's fine.
Yeah, but
yeah, yeah. Don't mention my mother. I don't
because
care.
Your mother is a Christian.
Forget about that. She's dear to me. That was my focal point anyway. My point
is love. Who are you with? And sending you to hell. But you will not go to hell.
My point.
By the prayers of your mother, you will not go to hell.
My point, no.
Your mother is praying for your soul. And I know Almighty God will hear your mother's prayer and send you. I respect your mother as a believer because you, why should I leave her? She's a believer. She brought you up in the way of Christ. Now you reject Christ and you go for Islam. That is not good. You went from light into darkness. How can you do that? How can you move from the dark from light into darkness? How can you do that?
You won't dictate to me to what I choose.
Oh, there you are. So you choose the darkness.
You
choose the darkness. Islam is darkness.
So you say
there is no light in Islam.
You can't prove it.
Are you mean? I'm proving it. Because the Quran is the word of only one man. Now watch this. You can talk whilst I'm looking for what I want to show you.
With this guy speaking, you never get a chance to put a point. You move from one point quickly. We don't know closure on one point. Oh, you reason like that. But brain, you have to reason like that. When you reason, you must have closure on a point.
That's so funny.
I like you, bro. I'm teaching you something.
I'm listening to you. Yeah.
When you reason on one point, get closure. That's when you learn something. When you quote Bible verse, don't quote part of it. Quote the full verse. That's how you do respect to the Bible verse. You should shame a Muslim for telling you that. That's why I went to my mother there. That was the only point I'm making right here. You could quote the Bible verse. You didn't quote a full Bible verse when you speak. He said many fallacy, and you think, okay, it's true. And you don't want someone to square. If I said many to your court, John 3 verse 16. You quote the word which is added to the text.
How do you know this?
Is that the man?
Yeah, but watch it.
You quote lies.
No, you are the one who's quoting lies.
You said for God's sake.
You believe in lies. And you don't want to accept.
You guys came. He's speaking for 4 minutes here. You quote John 3:16. For God so loved Israel is the only begotten Son. You read bigger tradition of it's a lie. It's not there in manuscript. You should quote it. Would you like to utter lies or
what about Romans? I mentioned Romans 10 verse 9 and 10. What about that?
We can give you that point after.
Then you go, well, Paul said. Paul is an apostle of Jesus Christ.
Can you
called and anointed by God to preach the gospel.
Can you answer my first point?
Do you accept that Saul became Paul?
Why do you tell a lie and quote begotten?
What is a lie?
Is that there?
No, you are the one who was.
Why do you add begotten to John
3:16? You are the one who believes a lie and you reject the truth.
Answer me.
Let me say this to you.
You are judging. Let him ask
him a question.
Aren't you a Muslim?
No.
You are a Muslim. We're trying to learn, man.
We're trying to learn from this debate.
You know, all of a sudden,
answer the question, then you can present your question.
They will keep talking and talking and talking. Earlier on, you mentioned, I said to you, that Jesus is the only one who can save.
Answer the question.
No, I'm asking you. Did I say Jesus is the only one who can save?
I'm not kidding about what you said in your head. I'm not about scripture.
I'm saying to you.
Really?
No. That's the problem. Father God, I pray for the Muslims that you will open your hearts to listen.
Liars,
that they will stop.
Liars cannot save no one.
You and listen.
You prove so many times to be a clear liar.
My point to you
lie in Bible scripture
is that Jesus Christ is the only one who can save.
You see what you agree? You don't want no one to hear.
Agree.
He quote John 3:16 and add
I'm
a word.
I'm asking you.
And begotten to.
What about Romans 10, 9 and 10? What about Romans 10, 9 and 10?
We're going to get there. Answer the first point.
What point?
Answer the first point. When you quote John 3:16,
yes.
The word begotten is not in that verse.
Can I finish? He wants to argue. Go on.
No.
You're so wise. You're so smart.
Why did you add a word to the scripture? Why do you add begotten to that verse?
Who added?
You added it when you quoted. Write it for them.
It's not in there. I put it in there.
You said for God.
I put it in there.
It's not there.
No, I'm asking you. I put it in there.
Is added.
But is it written there?
No, it's added.
Who added it?
You caught the quote.
No, no, no. Did I add it or the printers added? Who? Me or the printers?
It's not in manuscript. We got it in
no, wait, there, you see, this man is arguing about something that is written that I quoted. I only quoted what was written. And you tell me, oh, you don't like the Bible. You don't like the Bible. It wasn't in there. Who are you, a scholar?
You know.
How do you know it wasn't in
you
there?
Know because
I'm asking you.
Here.
I'm asking how
you know.
You know.
You know. He's a liar. You know.
Well, there you are. See, you're the one who's a liar. I only quoted what was written. And you tell me, oh, what you're saying is not true. But I quoted the scripture.
So you know.
And you don't agree. You don't agree. You are thinking
so you know
there's something else there.
You know because
and watch it.
You know because it's added. Answer me. You know it's added there.
Bro.
You know it's added.
Bro.
Answer me.
You are the one telling me.
Answer me.
You are the one telling me.
So you don't know the Bible then?
No.
So you don't know the Bible then?
He needs prayer. He needs prayer.
So you don't know the Bible then?
He needs your prayer. My point to you.
You could fabricate it.
My point to you is that you want to be a scholar of what you don't know. What you're saying is not true. What you're saying is not true.
What?
You need to repent from sin. 100%
true.
Repent from sin.
Look.
It's
a lie. The word.
You need to repent. Keep your life to Jesus Christ.
John 3:16. The word begotten is a fabrication.
Whose family do you
belong to? Are you called a fabricated
person? Are you part of Satan's family or God's family?
You called the fabrication.
Are you part of God's family or Satan's family?
I'm
asking you.
I don't quote
lies. Whose family do you belong to?
I don't quote lies.
Almighty God or Satan? Which one do you belong to?
You're not the part of God's family.
No. But you are.
You quote lies.
Who's God's
the
father?
Bible said God is.
Who's God's father?
The Bible said the devil is a liar.
Yeah, who's God's
father? You quoting lies. I didn't quote no lies. You don't quote lies.
So what is the quote? Tell me the quote, since you know it.
I'm asking you.
No, I'm asking you. You know what does it
I'm
quote?
I'm telling you.
Tell us what
the
is the scripture.
The word begotten is a fabrication.
No. Tell us.
So
tell us the real one. Tell us.
I'm telling you.
The real one says.
The word
for God. So no. Tell us the real one. See, that's what Islam does. Muslim will tell you, oh, it's wrong. It's wrong. Tell me the right one. Give us the right scripture. What it says.
I'm saying to you.
Give us the right one.
You quote the verse.
No. Quote us the right one.
Can you listen?
Yeah, I'm listening.
How do you quote? You quote.
Okay. No. Forget about my quote.
Can I speak?
Forget my quote.
This guy is
you have the right me. Quote. Give us the right
can
quote.
I speak?
I am wrong.
The verse.
You are right. Show us what is right.
What? The verse. I'm speaking. If you don't interrupt, I can give it. The verse. I'm giving you the verse. Read the verse. Read this without the current verse. Read this. For God so loved Israel, sent His only Son. The word begotten shouldn't be there. You know, every Bible scholar they put in footnote, no, it's a fabrication, interpolation. If you use a man of God, you don't repeat back fabricated words.
I like
you
that.
You don't do that.
Here is a Muslim mentioning that God so loved the world, He sent His Son.
I said the verse says that.
Wait. So let's remove the begotten. Let's take it out.
Oh, you read now.
So Jesus is the Son of God.
Yeah, say forgive begotten.
Is He the Son of God?
The verse says,
I'm asking you. Oh, I like that. The verse says He's the Son of God. So you are seeing that in the Christian scriptures,
the verses,
Jesus is mentioned as the Son of God.
So what? Even other man.
And I'm asking.
Even some prophets.
Yes, I was going to get to that.
Even some other prophets.
Which
man?
I was going to get to that. The Bible says many prophets, peacemakers.
Yeah, but Jesus.
Adam.
Jesus is it's not like, just.
Yeah.
It's not the Son of God like Adam is.
What do you mean?
We're not saying that.
That's a good one.
And it's funny, in Psalm 91, the only one that God called begotten son is not Jesus, it's David.
Man, after King James, man.
Look at what it says.
Virgin.
David was called.
It says, God, who at sundry times and in diverse manners speak in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days spoken to us by His Son, whom He has appointed heir of all things, by whom also He made the worlds, who, being the brightness of His glory, so Jesus is the brightness of the glory of God, and the express image of His person, upholding all things by the word of His power, when He had by Himself purged our sins, sat down at the right hand of the Majesty on high, being made much better than the angels, as He has by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. He's speaking about Jesus Christ being the express image. Look at what it says. Express image of God's person.
There's got an image. I can't buy it.
The express image of God's person. What don't you understand? God made us in His image. Making us in His image Jesus is the express image of God.
Why is that image?
Because human beings are made in the image of God. And so when Jesus became a man, he was made in the express image of God. That is why he's different than any human being.
Perfect.
He is the express image of God's person.
Are you preaching? Are you,
I'm telling you what was with you.
I can't abide with Jesus. He's got an image.
What do you mean? Jesus is the image of God. I'm saying to you, Jesus is the express image of God.
So I ask you what you mean. What is the image of Christ to you?
When God became a human being, he was manifested in the person of Jesus Christ.
Is the image of something you can see?
What do you mean?
The image of something you can see.
Of course, he was seen in Israel where he was preaching.
Is the image something you can see?
What don't you understand? I answered you right now. I said he was preaching in Israel at that time. Yeah, Jesus was preaching.
You said God is an image.
Those there saw him.
Yes.
Yeah. And so seeing Jesus, the express image of God's person. Now I can understand as a Muslim, you don't understand that like you can't in your mind you're kinda
you can't, all you're
talking about.
Forget about
I hear what you're saying.
About Bible verse.
Yeah, but I showed it to you.
What
you don't you want
say,
to know.
So what just the thermostat was looking at you?
Come again.
You said just image is God image. That's what you said.
I read it to you.
Please.
You always say, I said. The scripture says.
You quoted.
The scripture.
Say, so
not me. I didn't write it.
So I'm going to show you.
I believe it.
Wait.
That Jesus is the express image of God.
So concord.
And watch this.
Concord.
The conclusion today for you is that you need to repent from sin.
Can I speak?
Because Islam will send you straight to hell. I'm telling you, listen to me. As I speak to you right now. People are dying and going to hell. And I'm begging you, do not die and go to hell.
I don't do blind faith.
You need Jesus Christ. Not blind faith. No, I'm telling you. Listen, the scripture says, without the shedding of blood, there can be no forgiveness of sin. And I'm saying this to you, that Jesus Christ shed his blood for your sins to be forgiven. And if you reject it, you will die and go to hell. I appeal to you. I am begging you. Reason with the scriptures.
I want to reason
you
with
were
it.
Born in the
I want
scriptures.
To reason with it.
Your mother taught you the scriptures.
I want to reason
but
with
now
I want
you
to
believe
it.
A lie.
I want to reason
Islam
with
is not the scriptures.
Can I reason with this?
Islam is not the scriptures.
So I must
you, what do you mean blindly?
Can I ask a question?
You are following Islam blindly.
Can I ask a question?
You are following Islam blindly.
Right.
And then he said to me, should I believe the scriptures blindly? Or you follow Islam blindly, but you don't believe the scriptures.
No, can I?
Repent from Islam. Turn away from Islam and give your life to Jesus Christ. I pray that God will have
blessed. Why are you running? Why are you running?
Has been quite, I would say, a bit hectic in speaker's corner. And Muslims keep saying, teach us. I've never heard Muslims in speaker's corner. No, teach us. And you know what? They don't want to listen to nothing. How can you teach somebody who doesn't listen? Look, as I talk, he's on my side talking to you right now. Can you imagine? I'm speaking and speaking.
He's a speaker, he's a coward. He's a coward. You run. You say what?
You won't even allow me to speak.
He's a coward.
If you want to learn, you listen.
You can learn from you, but you don't know scripture.
But they come to speaker's corner. We want to learn. You don't want to learn. You want to hold to what you were holding to.
You believe a man is God.
Unfortunately for you, you were born a Christian. Now you're a Muslim. And I know your mother is praying for your soul. I also pray for you that Almighty God will deliver you from the darkness, because Islam is not the truth. You know, only Jesus Christ is the only way. Only Jesus Christ is the only truth, and he is the only life. I don't come to speaker's corner to win arguments. I come to tell people, repent from sin. Give your life to Jesus Christ. Allow the love of God to saturate you. And today, it's been one kind of argument, and this and that. And you know, speaking about Jesus, it was speaking in the Hebrew, in the scriptures in Hebrews 5 verse 7, it says, Jesus in the days of his flesh cried unto the Father who could save him from death. So they say, Jesus was crying for salvation. I said, look, that was in the days of his flesh. But it is the death of Jesus that saves us from our sins. And so I'm speaking about his death, not the days of his flesh. He died to save mankind. There is only one Savior, Jesus Christ. There is only one way, the cross of Jesus Christ. There is only one blood, the blood of Jesus Christ. And if you're a Muslim listening to me, I'm praying for you. I am really praying and weeping in my heart for you. Say, don't allow Islam to take you to hell. Because Islam is sending people to hell. Only Jesus is the Savior. And I pray that you will reason with the scriptures. I mentioned Paul. They say, who is Paul? Paul is an apostle of Jesus Christ. Paul was a man who was a murderer. He was murdering Christians. And then this man became one of the greatest preachers. Wrote more than most of the New Testament. Paul wrote it. Ask yourself, how can a man who was a murderer, murdering Christians with authority, become a believer and give his life to Jesus Christ? And so, this is my prayer. Believe in Jesus and you will now be the same again. And I pray for the Muslims in Speaker's Corner that God will open their ears. They say they want to learn, but they won't listen. And if you don't listen, you can't learn. And the way to learn is by listening. And I'm glad you're listening to Soko. Keep listening.
Thank you for your time. Bless you, brother. Cut!